If you listen to the voice of God, as the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 says, you will be filled with the blessing. If you are not listening to the voice of God, your life will be full of curses, obstacles and pain. The life of yours is determined whether you can listen to the voice of God. Your life is built on that premises. Though the Lord had blessed Sebna with grace and mercy, made him to be the king, to be born in the clan of David, but he never listened to the voice of God. He was worried about himself. What to build? How to become rich? Stupid man. God had made him the king. What more he needs? He got the riches for which he never earned, for which he never worked. But a man who holds on to riches, a man who holds on to self, can never satisfy them himself. Only in the Lord we are satisfied. So the Lord said to that king, stupid fellow, you have built tombs for yourself. Instead of bringing glory to God, instead of listening to the voice of God and directing yourself and the country, you have lived for yourself, and you will be thrown into the tomb which you yourself have prepared. And I will raise up an ordinary man, Eliakim, who will listen to my voice, who will take your place, and he will be a father. He will die to himself, and he will do my will. He will be father to the people in Jerusalem. He will bring glory to me. St. Paul says, who will understand the mind of God? Who can talk with God day and night? Are there anybody? Everyone is created for my glory. They've forgotten their purpose of their call, and they are living for themselves. Who will appreciate me? Who will make me great? Who will give me money? And they are mad after this world, and they will die with that. In the gospel, Jesus says to Peter, you are Peter. You are the rock. I will build my church on you. But that man did not understand the call of God. When Jesus spoke about death, he was trying to change the direction of Jesus himself. So the Lord said to him, get out, Satan. Get out, Satan. You may be a disciple, so what? Every disciples are not guaranteed to go to heaven. Only those who listen to the voice of God and obey the voice of God, they will enter in the kingdom of God. Jesus said, on that day, many will come and say, Lord, we spoke in your name. We did miracles in your name. He will tell us, I don't know you. Get out from here. Tie them and throw them into the dark. In John 10, verse 27 to 28, he says, my sheep will hear my voice. Because of that, they will never perish. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do you want to not to be perished? There is only one way. Train your heart and mind. Train your life to listen to the voice of God. If you don't train, the thing for which you are running after, that will destroy you. That will take you away from life, from God. Be careful, be alert. God's voice is unique. The voice of God created the world. The voice of God destroyed darkness. The voice of God created this beautiful world. That voice of God is being given to you that you may build up your relationship with him and your life may be renewed every day. Yes, that is the purpose of God speaking to us every day. Blessed is the man who listened to the voice of God. Yes, voice is unique, and God's voice too, it speaks of his personality. The voice symbolizes personality. When you hear the voice of your father who teaches you, you know. Immediately, you know, through this voice, God guides me. Through your husband, through your wife, when you hear that voice speaks to your life, every voice has got its own. When the child's voice is crying, immediately the mother knows that the child needs milk. Or with a cry, the mother knows that the child is in danger. Every voice communicates. And if you hear the voice of God, God will communicate to you. And without the voice of God, your life is without the communion with God. It is the communication will lead you to the communion. If you hear the communication, if you build your life in the communication of God, you will learn, you will land up in the communion with God. Without the communication, breaking the communication with God, you will lose the communion with God. It is only by listening to the voice of God again and again and again, you begin to recognize certain voices are not voices, they are noises. They are the noise of Satan. They are the noise of selfishness. They are the noise that come from the flesh. They are the noises come from the world. Only those who move to, they are used to listen to the voice of God. The Lord said in John chapter 10, verse 3 to 5, my sheep will listen to my voice. And by listening to my voice, they will understand my direction. And when the enemy comes, they will not run behind. Rather, they will run away from the voice of the enemy. The voice of God will help us with a gift of the Holy Spirit, which is known as discernment. It will help us to discern what is the voice of God. And by used to listen to the voice of God every day, you will run away from the noise of the enemy and you can build up your life. Without listening to the voice of God, your discernment will be attacked by the enemy. And you will not know what is from God, what is from the world. You will not know where the enemy is waiting to destroy you. Yes. Only those who are able to listen to the voice of God will be blessed with the beautiful gift of discernment.